took you to a baseball game. You brought along your baby doll and half its baby things. We sat there a-playing house while the Dodgers played the Braves. And everyone in the bleachers looked at us as if to say, all the day I took you on a fishing trip. You said, Daddy, won't that hook hurt the fish's lip? And you said, if they don't get air, those things in the can will die. So we turned the worms loose and chased some butterflies. The day that your young man come to call, seems like only yesterday we swam and played football. But I know the time has come that I must set you free. But no matter where you are, you know what you are to me.
Scripture tells us we can call him Abba, Father, and Abba is translated into Daddy, and so many times I addressed him that way. But I want to share a little bit this morning. But fathers, this is Father's Day, and we celebrate you this day. Ladies, you can stay seated, but please give applause to all our fathers here, please. Thank you very much. So as we begin today, I found this word for our church yesterday, and I had to put it in because I believe it is talking directly to us, and it is in the bulletin, underlined, "Do not be afraid, little flock, for it is your Father's pleasure to give you the kingdom." Let us worship and celebrate this day our Father in heaven. For many here were lost, but now are found. Many here were once far away, but you have been brought near by Christ Jesus himself. Many here were once dead, but alive again through God's love. Let us worship and celebrate indeed. As we come to our song of the day, Jessica.
Come, come, everybody worship.
Come, come, everybody worship. What a perfect day to worship on Father's Day.
Thank you.
as we begin with our prayer. God is forgiveness and grace. Please join with me in it, in our opening prayer. You'll find it there. God of forgiveness and grace, thank you for welcoming us so warmly and lovingly. Please open our hearts that we may fully receive your grace and love. Please bless us and renew us that we may live as new creations you envision us to be. Please inspire us to your kingdom on this earth, that we may be your promised land with words that soothe like honey and actions that nourish like milk. Amen. Please, you may be seated. Let us go to the call to worship. Lord, the faithful have come and entered the house of God. For this is our hiding place, where the one who always loves us is waiting. May our cries be heard and our sins forgiven. May our worship be a blessing to one and all. What an amazing time to be here this morning on Father's Day in the presence of the Father. And you know, his presence is here this day, and he has a personal reason to be here this day, because he knows each and every one of you and everything about you, and his love is always there, because he is always watching over us. Even in those times when we don't think he is there. For he knows us, and he knows how much we love and care for him. What a blessed Father we have in heaven and our fathers here on earth, O Lord. So let us please bring our prayer of confession before the Lord God Almighty, to cleanse our heart and make us whole, Lord, and to set us free. So please join together. Loving Father, hold us in your arms of your forgiveness and grace when we run from you or abandon your guiding light. Welcome us back with mercy when we squander your gifts or reject your generosity. Love us into right living when we hide from the shame of mass or guilt. Coax us into the light of your abandoned love. Hear our prayers, dear Lord. Be our hiding place of hope and joy, that we might say with the psalmist, happy are those who forgive. Amen. Please, as we stand together and sing the Gloria Patri. Be seated. As I looked for what I would do on Father's Day, what kind of sermon would I do on Father's Day? And all I could think of was Paul's words was, don't let a woman load it over you. And okay. My thought was that is next time I'm going to get a man to do this, not me. So I searched diligently through there. And the only one I could really find about, there's many fathers that are in here, but for Father's Day, the one that really struck my heart right away was the parable of the lost son. And one of the writers said it should have actually been titled The Parable of the Loving Father. And I agree with him. And so that's where we're headed today, is it's about the prodigal son, but it's how the father reacts to the son. And so, and he had enough challenges before him. It's not written in the scriptures, but you that are married know that this would not have been an easy thing for him one way or the other. So a certain father had two sons. The younger son of them said, Father, give me a portion of the goods that falls to me. And so he divided to him his livelihood. Now just think about that in your own families. That your child comes up, your youngest child comes up and says, wait a minute, I want my part right now. And the father knew what he was going to do with it. And the father decides that he's going to give it to him. Do you think there was a conversation between the mother and the wife and the father? And you think how many times the father says, what am I going to do here? And how dumb am I for giving him everything? Because he's too young. He doesn't know enough. And all the money that I give him, he will go out and he will just go out and blow that. And so the father decides. He gives it to him. He said, okay. And I can see the wife standing over here, his shoulder, and said, are you nuts? Okay, let's be real. That's the topic would have been. So, but the father gave him what would belong to him, one third. So, because he had another son. So he divided it, and he gave it to him. And it didn't take long. And not many days after the younger son, what do you think he did? He gathered all together everything that he had, and he journeyed to a far country. And there, what did he do? He wasted absolutely everything with fast living and spent absolutely everything. One third of the father's, he could have just as well put it on a match and burnt it on the floor. Because he got rid of absolutely everything. And the father's at home, you know that, wondering, what is the son doing? And where did he go? And scratching his head, if he really did the right thing by him. But the son has to learn, and sometimes the lessons are really hard. And I don't know if that was the father thinking about that. He needs to go out and learn. And so out he went. And not many days after he got there, the younger son had a blast. When he had spent everything, took him a while, lots of fun, lots of stupid, dumb things. Doesn't say that in the scriptures, but you know with young people, they're not really intelligent either at that age. So, but he spent, and he spent it all. And there he was. And there arose a severe famine in that land. And he began to be in want. Now he has no money even to buy himself food. He's already gotten rid of that. And so he figured out he had to do something. Then he went and he joined himself to a citizen of that country. And he went into the fields to feed the swine. In Israel, in the law of the Jewish law, you are cursed if you went out and fed the swine. And he would have known that. Now he knows, even in his own heart, he has no money, he spent all his father's money and everything, and now he is also being cursed by God because he is breaking the law and not being obedient. So he was there, and he would gladly have filled his stomach with the pods, with what he's feeding the pigs. He would rather ate it himself than feed it even to the pigs that the swine ate, and no one there gave him anything. He realized he was totally upon his own. And sometimes it takes that hunger within that you can't do anything about, that your brain finally kicks in and comes back, and finally the son is the one that say, oh, how stupid I am. What did I do? And they put it a little bit different in the scriptures. But when he came to himself, and is that not what we say when we came to ourselves? Why did I do that? Why? And why did I blow it all? But he finally came to himself, and he said, and he looked, how many of my father's hired hands and servants, they have enough bread they have bread to spare, and I perish here with hunger. I will confess, it was not an easy choice for him to make. It's never an easy choice to go back and tell somebody that I made a mistake, I really blew it. But he gathered all that he could within him. And his thoughts in his mind were great. I will confess, and I will go back to my father. And I will say to him, because I'm sure that was one of the words that he had in his brain. What am I going to tell him? What am I going to say to him? Dad, I blew all your money? What am I going to say? But I will go back and say to my father, Father, I can hear his voice breaking up on this, truthfully, because it's hard to get this out. Father, I have sinned against heaven and before you. I am no longer worthy even to be called your son. Make me like one of the servants. And he arose and came to his father. But when he was still a great way off, his father saw him and had compassion and ran and fell on his neck and kissed him. And the words in here, but when he was still a great way off. How many days do you think the father went out looking for him? I believe that father went out there every day just to watch for him. And the longer the time that he was gone, the more the father went out to see if he could see him returning. Because it says he was a long ways away. And the father could tell just by him coming that it was his son, that he was alive. Because the father didn't know if he was alive or if he was dead at all. And he couldn't stand there. Think of this. He couldn't stand there and wait for the son to get to him. He was so excited and so anxious. And what did he do? He ran out to the son. And I could imagine if the son saw his father run, the son would have also ran also. And they collapsed, truthfully, in each other's arms because his father did not know if he was dead or if he was alive. But now, what does he know? He's alive. He's alive. I have my son back. There had to be a dance out there with this. There had to be a dance there with this. This had to take a little while just to look and talk with each other and tell each other how much they love each other. And the celebration would have been great. It had been great. There's nothing ever said about this, about Mom, but can't you imagine them both going back and seeing Mom too? And the dance went on there that this son was brought back again to. As he rose and he came to his father, and he looked for home in his heart. He needed home. He needed a place where there was family and there was friends. And somebody had asked me, why do you think he left in the first place? Well, sometimes when you got an older brother, they can be pretty hard on you. But nobody knows why he left. But he came back. So and the son said again to the father, I have sinned against heaven in your sight, and I'm no longer worthy to be called your son. He repeated that to his father twice. No longer worthy. But the father said to his servants, bring out the best robe and put it on him. Put a ring on his hand and sandals on his feet. By the symbol of the robe, the father was accepting him back as he was. And as he looked at the best to put the ring on his finger and the ring on his hand, and if it would have been the right ring, his dad was actually handing over a power authority to him. And the son is still, how can this be? It has to be. But he said, and then, because he had already told his dad, I'll be a slave for you. I've already taken whatever I should. I'll be a slave for you. And the dad came and he said to the servants, go, get him some shoes. He has to have shoes on him. Because slaves do not wear shoes. And he wanted his son to know that he was bringing him back fully into the family, and he needed shoes on his feet for this day and beyond, because the father had forgiven him completely. How amazing. So, and not only that, bring the fatted calf and kill it, and let us eat and make merry and have a party and celebrate, for my son is returned. For this son was dead and is alive again. He was lost and he's found. And they begin to make merry. How many hallelujahs went up? There would have been huge for this boy. But there's always kind of sometimes that makes it a little bit more difficult. But he remembered too. Now the older son was in the field. And as he came and drew near the house, he heard the music and the dancing. He did not know his brother was back yet. So he called out to one of the servants and asked, what does these things mean? What's going on? Good question. And he said to him, your brother has come home. And because he has received him safely back and sound, your father has killed the fatted calf. And the son was not happy. In fact, the son became very angry at that. He really didn't care if his brother was back or not. But he was very angry. And this beautiful parent, what does he do? He goes out to his second son, the first son, and he talks with him. He went out to plead with him, to please come to the party. Please come and celebrate with us. So he answered and said to the father, he was very angry, lo, these many years, doesn't say how many, but these many years I have been serving you. I have never transgressed your commandment at any time. And yet you never gave me a young goat that I might make merry with my friends. But as soon as this son of yours came, who has devoured your livelihood with harlots, you killed the fatted calf for him. And the youngest son, the oldest son, is the only one that mentions him doing anything evil. He was very angry. And sometimes we get that way. Look how you treated them. Look how you've been treating me. And I'm sure this father was treating him with honor and respect. And if he would have said to a dad, I want a party, do you think the dad would have held back? No, he would not have held back. Not if he can give abundantly to the younger son, he would not have held back anything from the older son. But the older son never asked at all. And so, but he says to him, with the heart of a father, a dear heart of a father, from one about one son to another son, he answered and said to his father, lo, these many years I have been serving you, and yet you never gave me a young goat. But he said, son, you are always with me. The son had been faithful, and he was always there. And you have always been with me. And all that I have is yours. The young son had already got his inheritance. The rest of what is here, son, is all yours. It is all yours. And it was right, he tells him, that we should have a party for your brother. Because to us, he was dead, and now he's alive. So he doesn't tell him, I want you to go up there and give him a big hug and welcoming home. He might have done that after he decided that everything that the father had is already his anyway. So why be mad anymore? Go welcome home. But what an amazing father this is, that he addressed both of these boys. And as fathers here, you have many choices, many decisions to make over and over again. And sometimes, like the women too, we don't understand what our kids are doing or why they do it. And we don't know sometimes the right words to say to them either, to change their minds. And sometimes we can't change their minds at all anyway. So what we can do is continue to love them. Continue to call on them. This morning there was a special thing that came over on the internet for Donnie this morning from his son. Happy Father's Day, Dad. This was quite a Father's Day for both the sons and the dad. And I believe the father worked at this all the way through. It doesn't tell us that, but what we know from what he did, I believe he worked on them two boys together until they were back together as a full family in full course and rejoiced and had parties together because everybody was back and at the same place and actually understood each other. We have an amazing God. He gives us our scriptures that have amazing stories that tell us and show us what to do always. And I am so grateful and so thankful for the men of this congregation and the fathers that they are and what they have taught their sons also, how to love the Lord Jesus Christ and how to be loved by the Lord God Almighty. Today, we celebrate. And we also celebrate those that came before us and taught us. And our song is Faith of Our Fathers. Let's hit that one. Please be seated. We have a little bit of a time here. Is there anybody that has a testimony that they would like to share this morning? Okay. All right. So, I know in my own life, my father was a gentleman. A very gentle man. He died at a very young age of 53. So I lost my father at the age of 19. So miss him dearly. But so let your kids know how much you love them. Even when they act like this young man did. But The song this morning that we first sang is one the girls would sing to Donnie over and over again when it came up. So he was the one that brought it up, that maybe today that would work good. That all about daughters. So do we have any prayer requests this day? Bev?
My nephew had a child that was born at 1 pound.
Ooh.
12 ounces back in February.
Yeah.
She's home and she weighs 9 pounds.
Ooh.
9 ounces.
Praise the Lord. Yeah. Praise the Lord. Beth?
We have a granddaughter that turns 16 on the 16th today, and she's such a sweet, such a sweet girl and has such a heart for God. So
wonderful.
Just praise and thank God for her every day.
What's her name, Beth?
Brielle.
Ria?
Brielle.
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 Yeah. Thank you.
I think there. Okay. There we go. So
I'd like to put Debbie, our niece's significant other, Lee. He's doing some testing for some blood work. So I don't have any details, but he just needs lots of prayers. His name is Lee Rams.
Okay. All right.
Could we pray for our neighbors?
Sure.
They are having a trouble transition to long-term care.
Ooh. Yes, that would be difficult. So, do you want a name or not? Okay, no, that's good. That's good. So, we see we have a boot on instead of a cast on today. So keep praying, okay? So, it's moving along pretty slowly, but keep at it. So, anything else this morning? So, okay, then you're stuck with me again. Okay, here we go. All right. Heavenly Father, as we come before you this morning, we are so filled with gratitude that your love showers over us. And you remind us so many times that your presence is right there with us. So we pray for this little baby, Lord, that is now at 9 pounds. And yep, when they're that tiny as a pound, it's like a teacup almost that you're holding in your hand. They're so little. So we thank you, Lord, and praise you for the healing that you have processed here and brought her through. And we pray for Brielle, oh Lord, at 16 years old, Lord, which is a very tentative time in a life of a young person in our nation. We ask for your protection around her, oh Lord. We ask for your hand to rest upon her, oh Lord, and that she can hear you whispering her name to her over and over again, and she knows that it is you, that she is precious in your sight, O Lord. For her we celebrate this day with her birthday. And we pray for Lee, Lord, who is going through some tests through his blood, O Lord. We ask, O Lord, that you will give the doctors wisdom, that they know exactly what they're doing and no guessing, Lord. But Lord, we ask the Lord Jesus Christ, you, to lay your hand upon him. For you, the Lord Jesus, know exactly how precious the blood is when you shed it for us, O Lord. So we ask, O Lord, your touch to be upon him, that he will amaze the doctors totally and completely and come through there with a bill that says, you are good and you can go home and we didn't find anything because of the precious touch of Jesus Christ upon him, O Lord. We pray, Lord, for the couple that are in long-term care. It's something that we've known all of our lives, and we've watched our people that we love be put in there and struggle with it over and over again because it's not home. But we ask, O Lord, that your gentle peace would enter into their hearts and Just settle them, O Lord, and they will begin to see things that are coming that are good things that they enjoy, and they have a time there that they become comfortable, Lord. Your peace be with them and your joy surround them, O Lord. And help them, Lord. If they're an older couple, they know your hymns, O Lord, that your songs will arise within them as they celebrate the day. We thank you for them, Lord. In the blessed name of Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior. Amen. Anything else for the day? Okay, then please join me in the Lord's Prayer. Our Father, who art in heaven,
hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory. Amen.
We're not quite done yet. We have one more song. You can't just have one about daughters. You have to have one about a son also. Okay, you got to do the whole thing. So, Jessica, this is a song my kids loved as kids.
The future of your business is here. With Wix, you get advanced AI capabilities.
So. Got it?
Hey, little bear. Where'd you learn that song?
You, Daddy.
Oh, you ready to go? Okay.
Driving through town, just my boy and me, with a Happy Meal in his booster seat, knowing that he couldn't have the toy till his nuggets were gone. Traffic light turned straight to red. I hit my brakes and mumbled under my breath. His fries went a-flying and his orange drink covered his lap. Well, in my four-year-old said a four-letter word. It started with S and I was concerned. So I said, son, now where'd you learn to talk like that? He said, I've been watching you, Dad, ain't that cool? I'm your buckaroo, I wanna be like you and eat all my food and grow as tall as you are. We got cowboy boots and camo pants, yeah, we're just alike, hey, ain't we, Dad? I wanna do everything you do. So I've been watching you. Back home and I went to the barn. I bowed my head and I prayed real hard. Said, Lord, please help me help my stupid self. The next side of bedtime later that night, turning on my son Scooby-Doo night light. He crawled out of bed and he got down on his knees. Closed his little eyes, folded his little hands, spoke to God like he was talking to a friend. And I said, son, now where'd you learn to pray like that? He said, I've been watching you, Dad, ain't that cool? I'm your buckaroo, I wanna be like you and eat all my food and grow as tall as you are. Some things and holding mama's hand, yeah, we're just alike, hey, ain't we, Dad? I wanna do everything.
watching you. Okay? Boys and girls. And when they get to teenage, they still watch. But they talk back a lot. But whatever. Okay. But, so, all right. So, at this time, we'll actually have receive our gifts and our offerings, please. Father, you have placed so many things in our hearts that we can't even sometimes figure out, but you are always with us. Lord, we give these gifts unto you. They come from our hearts and from our labor and from who we are because it's our love for you. So we thank you, Lord. Please bless and multiply for your use in the kingdom of God, in the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior. Amen. God bless. Thank you. Okay. One more, a little bit. Heavenly Father, I pray for all of these men that are here today, that your blessings will touch each and every one of them, Lord, that they will know when they leave here that they have been touched by the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. And you're saying unto them, good job. Good job to show your children how to love me and how to care for one another. They are doing a superior job, Lord. So your presence always with them as you guide them and lead them on this journey of life here to be a wonderful example to all of their children around them. In your precious name we pray. Amen. God bless. Please be seated. Our last song is Faith of Our Father. This is my Father's world. Thank you, Jessica. Are we ready? This is my Father's world. Ooh, I'm almost done. Yep, back up. Thank you. a standing applause for our Father God. Come on. Come on. Oh, Lord God, we just celebrate you. Go in the grace and the peace and the love of the Lord Jesus Christ, being filled every day with him. In his holy name we pray. Hallelujah and amen. And God bless. Have a wonderful day, fathers.